This is your basic body's single dotted pattern. Okay, there is a dot in the waistline, right? A dot, a waist dot is there in this body. Am I right? Am I right? Okay, 1 minute. I will just share. So as you can see this, see my screen, right? So you can see the outline of a basic bodies. Am I right? You can see the outline of a basic bodies, and all the labelings and the lines indicate on which all places you can place a dot. Okay. So you can. So I will just share my screen again. So suppose this is your basic bodice. Suppose this is your basic bodice. The dot, this dot is called waist dot. Okay. This one is waist dot. Apart from that, you can have a dot here in the center front. Okay. You can have a dot here in the side seam. Okay. You can have a dot in the nape. You can have a dot in the neckline. You can have a dot in the shoulder tip. You can have a shoulder dot. You can have a dot here. You can have a dot here. You can have a dot here. Here. Okay. Like this, you can have a dot in these many places. Okay. Okay. Not just shoulder dot, not just waist dot. Apart from these 2 points, you can create dot, you can place a dot in these many points. Okay. So now you are having, okay, now you are having a basic bodies with a dot, with a waist dot. Okay. Now you are having a basic bodies with a waist dot. Okay. Waist dot. First, you need to mark. So you are having a basic bodies with a waist dot. Am I right? This is a basic bodies. This is a basic bodies with what? This is a basic bodies with
Where start?
waist dot. Suppose you want to transfer this waist dot into. Suppose you want to transfer that waist dot to this point, which is middle of your armhole. Okay. You want an armhole dot. Okay. You want to place, you want to transfer this waist dot into a armhole dot. Okay. Into that point, you want to transfer your waist dot. Okay, you want to transfer the position. You want to change the position of your dot. So first, you need to mark that particular line. I hope you can see different lines on my. Is it visible? It's not clear, I know. You can see, right? Here there is a line, and here also the top part also there is some lines. So there are lines, just like how we sew here. I have marked few of these lines on my basic bodies. Okay. On my basic bodies, just like this, I have marked few lines. So now what we are going to do is that I'm going to transfer this waist dart into an armhole dart. Okay. I'm going to transfer this waist dart into armhole dart. So what are we supposed to do first? We have a line, right? We have a line that points toward the mid of your armhole. First, you need to cut it. First, you need to cut that line. You shouldn't cut it completely because you shouldn't cut it till your bust point. You shouldn't cut it till your bust point. Okay. So if this is your basic bodies, you are going to cut, this is your bust point. Okay. This is your bust point. And now you are going to create a dart here. Okay. Now you are going to transfer this waist dart into armhole dart. Okay. So first you are going to cut it. Cut this line. You are going to cut this line, but not till your bust point. But not till your bust point. Just before it. You can just stop it 1/4 inches before it. Okay. Just stop 1/4 inches or 0.2 inches before it. Okay. Stop. And now, as you can see, I have cut it. There is a cut on my dart. Okay. So now I need to close this. I need to transfer this waist dart into an armhole dart. So what I'm supposed to do, I just need to close this dart. So automatically a dart is being created on your armhole. Automatically, this waist dart is being transferred to your armhole. Is that clear? Is that clear? Okay. So what if you want to create two dotted pattern? You want an armhole at your, you want a dart at your armhole and waistline. You just don't need to close it completely. Now you have two dotted basic bodies, one at waist and one at your armhole. Okay, you just need to trace it down onto another. You just need to use ball pins or push pins. You just need to place it over another paper, above a chart paper, and then you just need to trace it down. Is it clear? Is it clear? So now you have an armhole dart and a waist dart. Okay. So what if you want a dart instead of this armhole? Okay. Instead of armhole, what if you want a dart at the shoulder line? You want a shoulder dart. What if you want to transfer this waist dart into your shoulder? Just like how we did right now. Just like how we transferred this waist dart into armhole, we just need to create another cut. So using my scissors, I'm going to cut my pattern. I'm going to cut the shoulder line. So as I said, you shouldn't cut till where? Anyone? Anyone, what are you supposed to do? Raina. How will you transfer your waist dart to shoulder? What are you supposed to do? Raina, am I not audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What are you? Yes.
Make a cut over there, like make a dart.
What cut? Where are you supposed to stop when you make a cut? So this is the pattern. This is the basic body's pattern. Now I'm going to transfer this waist dart to my shoulder. Transfer it to a shoulder dart. So I made a cut. I marked my mid shoulder line, princess point. Then I cutted it just above my bust point, 1/4 inches above my bust point. Then I closed my waist dart, opening a shoulder dart. Okay. When I closed my waist dart, automatically a dart was created in the shoulder line. Okay. What if I want both waist dart and shoulder dart? What if I want waist dart and shoulder dart? Sharon. What am I supposed to do if I want both waist dart and shoulder dart? What am I supposed to do? I explained how to transfer waist dart to your armhole. Did I explain how to transfer your waist dart to a armhole dart? Did I explain how to create both armhole dart and waist dart? Just the similar way, you can just create both waist dart and armhole. By keeping your waist dart, you can open a shoulder dart. How will you do it? What am I supposed to do if I want both? What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? So I want a dart. I'm having this dart already. I have this dart. Okay. And I want a dart here on my shoulder. What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? I explained how to transfer it to shoulder. I explained how to transfer your waist dart to shoulder. I explained how to transfer your waist dart to armhole. I explained how to keep both by keeping the waist dart, how to open an armhole dart. Just the same way, anyone, not just Sharon, anyone. I want to know whether you are absorbing whatever I'm telling, whatever I'm explaining in the class. I would like to know it. So just me just blabbering something, or whether you guys are understanding something, because this is the most anyone could do. I brought a pattern. I'm explaining it like this. I showed you a video on dart manipulation. So yes, I want an answer this time. Yes.
Do not close the shoulder dart. So we get two darts.
We are having, in my hand, there is a waist darted basic borders pattern. Okay. Now I want a shoulder dart.
Open the shoulder dart. Don't keep it closed.
By closing the waist dart, a shoulder dart will be formed. Okay. So what if I want both waist dart and shoulder dart?
Both should be open.
Just because I closed a waist, a shoulder dart was formed. Just because I closed the waist dart, a shoulder dart was formed. Am I right? So how can I keep both? That is the question. Yeah, I explained it once.
By closing the armhole.
No, armhole dart is not there. Armhole dart is not there. Armhole dart is not there. You just don't have to close it completely. You just don't have to close your waist dart completely. Now you have both, right? You have a shoulder dart and you have a waist dart. Am I right? Am I right? You just don't have to close the waist dart completely. Then you will have both. Right? Now your pattern is having one shoulder dart and one waist dart. Just the same goes with your armhole dart also. You just don't have to close it completely. Okay. So now I want you to make one. Do it on your own. Develop a mini version of your basic bodies and do dart manipulation. You can just transfer your waist dart or shoulder dart into any point. As you can see in the screen, you can place your dart. You can have waist dart, you can have shoulder dart, you can have neck dart, you can have neckline and center front intersection dart, which is this point. You can have center front dart. You can have center front dart. You can have center front waistline dart. You can have a French dart. This is French dart. You can have side seam dart, which is this one and this one. You can have armhole dart. And you can have a shoulder tip or flank dart. Okay. So I want you to transfer. You can take a shoulder darted basic bodies. You can draw a waist darted basic bodies. I just want you to transfer that dart into any of these points. If you are taking a waist darted basic bodies pattern, then I want you to transfer it to any other points. And if you have any doubt, just let me know now itself. No, dear, you don't have to make a back bodies pattern. Just make a front bodies pattern. For now, you don't have to use the exact measurements. Just draw the outline. Just mark a bust point. Just draw a dart anywhere. Waistline, bust point, shoulder line, wherever it is. And I just want you to mark all those 13 lines as seen in this figure. And I want you to transfer your dart using dart manipulation technique. So dart manipulation can be done using two methods, pivot method and slash and spread method. The method that we are learning right now is called slash and spread. Whoever is done, please unmute yourself and show me your work, okay? just don't cut the line or dart, whatever it is. Just don't cut it till bus point, okay? If you cut it till bus point, then it will get separated. The pieces will get separated, okay? So you shouldn't cut it till the bus point. Bus point is this center point. So you shouldn't cut it till there. You should stop just before that point, okay? Anyone done? Anyone? Meghna, are you done? Okay. Sharon? Okay. Yes. No. Okay. You are not able to move it, right? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the thing is that how does your pattern look like? Your basic bodies. Your basic bodies. Looks like this, right? Looks like this. Your completed basic bodies look like this. There will be nothing here. Okay. There will be nothing here. Why is it like that? So while developing a basic body, first it will be like this. And because of the shoulder slop, and on the shoulder slop, there will be one bust. On the shoulder slop, we will mark our bust depth. Am I right? We will mark bust depth and then we will extend this line. And from center front, we will measure our bust point and then we will mark it. And by 3 by 4 inches down, and we will just extend it. And from 3 by 4 inches down, we will mark another point and we can just mark it C1. And if the dot is, if we are going to create 1-inch dot on both the sides, that 1 inch will be divided on both the sides, 1/2 inches here and 1/2 inches here. And then we will join this. That's how we will get a triangular dot. Then using a scissor, we will just remove this center part. Okay. We will just remove the center part. Okay. So just do it like that. So if you remove that center part, instead of just cutting, when you are transferring the waste dot into another dot, you will be just cutting that line. Okay. So a dot void will be there in the waste dot. So you might have cut the center part, just divide, just create a triangular dot and cut that triangular off, and then try to transfer your waste dot into your armhole dot or shoulder dot, wherever you want. Okay. Okay, so this is my pattern. This is my front bodies without any dot. Okay, this is my front bodies without any dot. Okay, So now I'm going to create a dot. So first I will mark a bust point. First I will mark my bust point. Okay, first I will mark my bust point. Then I will extend that down. I will just demonstrate it in the board. So suppose this is my basic bodies without dot. I will mark my bust point. Then I will extend this line. I'm going to have a 1-inch dot. And I'm going to divide this 1 inch on both sides. Then I will just join this into the bust point. Okay. So I did. Now I will just cut that dot out. I will just cut that dot out. See. I just cut that dot out. So now you have a triangular dot. And now if I want a if I want to transfer this waist dot into an armhole dot, I just need to mark the midpoint of my armhole. Then I need to cut a straight line straight into my bust point without touching my bust point. Then now what I need to do is that I just need to close my waist dot to open a armhole dot. Anyone? Is anyone done? Steffi?
Ma'am, I understood. I've drawn it, but I didn't bring the scissors to cut it.
Okay. Raina?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you done?
Yeah, kind of, but I'm not able to move.
Okay, can you show me?
But I'm trying to make the move.
Okay. What is the problem, dear? Yes, the dart part is fine.
Like, if I cut till the end, the board...
You just don't have to cut till the end. Just stop it just before, okay? Stop it just before so that it will not get detached. No. So your dart is still here, right? So you just need to cut it. You just need to cut it just above that bust point. Cut it till... I will just share my screen. Okay, so this is your dart. Right now, this is your dart. And you need to create a dart here. So you just need to cut till here. You just don't touch the bust point, okay? Just avoid cutting it till the bust point. Stop it just above it. So then you can easily move it. You can just easily transfer your waist dart to your armhole without separating the... Okay. It will not get detached then. Okay. So please take a picture and send it to me. I will just go through it. Okay. It's time for us to wind up the class. Thank you. Thank you all. And I will ask you to demonstrate it in the next class, which is on Thursday. So please be aware about it. Okay. Okay. Bye.